Hi there, hello and welcome to my first video. I'm Lucas, I'm an SLA, I'm on my pyjama right now, I'm at home in Portugal, I'm Portuguese. If my English is not so good, it's because of that. I'll put the blame on the Portuguese side. So today I'm going to explain how to use this. Quite simple, but I'm paid to do this, so I'm going to show you. You have this, which means a clapperboard. If you're using a dual system, you're going to use this. What's a dual system in the first place? So a dual system is when you're recording in your boom, in your pole. You have a shotgun right there, recording, and that's being transmitted to your Zoom handy recorder. And then you're filming on camera as well, on your DSLR, C100, whatever it is. And you have a file being recorded with image and a file being recorded with sound. When you go to edit those files, edit your short, you need to sync them. So this helps the editor a lot. Editors, if you're editing and your guys don't use this right, you're... Yeah, basically, how does this work? It's quite simple. You need to clap this upper part like this, what they do in film, so it's kind of easy. But basically, clapping this makes a very distinctive sound. And also, it's very distinctive to see in the image, and you can perfectly see once this claps. So when the editor gets the files, they can put the sound, and they see on the timeline where it's that big wave of sound, which is this sound. And then there's a truck going by. You can also see in the image, you go frame by frame when this claps. When this claps, you can align both of them. How do you use it when you're shooting? Basically, what you need to do is prod. You put the name of your beloved producer. Or you can also put the name of the film. I love this one. This film is kind of great. And then we have roll. We don't use roll. I mean, this is when we used to shoot in film. When I say we, I mean older people, like your parents or so. Okay, so what you can put in here instead is SD card. You put SD card. I know, listen, apparently someone made a mistake on yesterday's video, so I need to fix. This is one of the wonders of editing, but that's another lesson. So yeah, today's a different day, different clothes, different lights, okay? Basically, you can put in the roll SD, which stands for SD card, which is what you have in the camera to film. Using the clapperboard, you have different systems. And the one they're teaching you right now, it's a different system than what I normally use, at least on this part. But you're going to understand in a bit. So they ask you to put the SD card. And this means, you know, you put it 001, which is the first card that you're going to use on the first day of your shoot. And when the day goes by, and when the card is getting full, it's good if you change it. Otherwise you... So when you change it, then you change this one and you put 002. There's also another way to do things, which is you need to ask your teachers if you actually... Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. Instead of putting SD card, this is how Portuguese people, at least I do it, you put something quite important that it's not here and it's not going to be unless you put it, which is SHOT. And what does SHOT stands for? It's not the one that you go to. And the SHOT is basically when the director is breaking down the script or doing the storyboard, each scene is going to have a different shot. For example, if scene number 7, which is the one that you're shooting, has 3 shots and you want to start from the last shot because of light, because of weather, because of whatever the reason it is, you put it here. So, shot number 3 of scene number 7. And scene, it's easy guys, come on. Scene, it's the scene of the script. You have one scene, the first scene, 2 scenes. And then you have the take. And the take is basically the number of repetitions that you're going to do this scene, this shot. We are going to need to replace this number a lot because we're amateurs and we make a lot of mistakes, yeah. Okay guys, so I just cleaned my mistake and now I'm going to clip on using the other video because I'm very lazy, okay? Goodbye! And then you have the name of the narcissistic bastard, which is the director, of course, as always. Okay, yes, great, right? And you can have camera or, if you want, you can edit DOP, okay? DOP. DOP, that's what I meant. And you put his name as well, right there. Yeah. And then we have the date, which is the day that you're shooting. It's not very essential, but if you have different days of shooting, it's important for you to know which day it was. And then you have day and night. If you're doing a scene at day, you cover night, okay? You can cover with something darker than this. If you're doing a scene at night, you cover the one that says day. And then you have interior and exterior. If your scene is indoors, you cover this up and you know it's a scene at night, exterior in a park, for example. Let's not focus too much in sync and filter is not very important. This is the main thing that you need to know and to say. And then the first ED or the director, if you don't have a lot of people. In my case right now, I'm the only one here, one man show. But if you have more people, for example, the first AD who have the clapperboard, he asks for the camera, you ready, bro? He say, yes, I'm ready. Sound, you ready? And they say, no, and come on, Jack, just do it, you know? But when they're ready, they'll tell you we're all ready, and you say, okay, so camera rolling. They say rolling. Sound, they say speed, or they say yes, or put the finger up, I don't know. And then you're ready to clap. You need to make sure that the camera is nicely framing this and the sound is close enough so it can hear the clap. That's important, of course. And when you're framing this, be careful with the lenses that you're using, because if this is too close and is being cut out, you're not going to understand. And also, be careful with your lenses when you have something like, for example, 100 or 85, that is a real close-up. You need to be careful with the focus, if you want the focus to be right there so you can read it. And also, yeah, be really careful not to, you know guys, not to cut this. For example, this doesn't help anyone. This is no use because you can't see really the clapping, and that's the important part of it. And then everyone is ready, everything is nicely framed and everything, so you're going to say, you don't need to say all of this, you just say, scene 7, shot 3, take 1, and you clap it. Another thing is important, when you're reading it out, always have the clapperboard open, because this way the editor, when he's scrolling through, he's going to see this open. If you're doing this like this, he can think, oh, shot, they already clapped it and I didn't saw it, so I need to see it all again. So, when everybody's ready, yes, ready, Jack, everyone, sound rolling, okay, great, so let's do it. So, shot 3, scene 7, take 1. That's it, guys, that's it. And also another thing, when you're going to clap close to the actors, imagine that you have a close-up, so you have a shot that's really like this. You need to be careful not to clap the clapperboard in front of their faces. This is not pleasant, guys. This is not pleasant at all. So always try to go a little bit to the side or go a little bit further so the actor doesn't have this clapperboard clapping on his face. It's not nice, okay? So have that in mind. Also, guys, please do not put the finger here, okay? Come on, you're not kids, you know. Unless you want this kind of sadistic kind of thing going on. Otherwise, do not put the finger here, okay? Do not hurt yourself, come on. Thank you very much, guys. Hopefully, you learned something with this. Hopefully. And if I don't get fired, I'll see you again soon, anytime. Hopefully, as I said. Now, go. Get the hell out of here. Go shoot something. Go do something, goddammit. Bye.